Alright, niggas, shut the fuck up and pay attention. M.O.B. Nigga, cause we mob on you tricks.
And you know we keeping money over bitches.
M.O.B. Nigga, cause we mob on you tricks.
And you know we keeping money over bitches.
Now I've been known to bust on sock. God bless my crazy life, la vida loca, homie, living that thug life. Been raised in violence, homicides, my lullaby. Hang with the homies and learn to kick it until we die. Boss players, you wonder why. I live the life of a ghetto kingpin, just let me ride. Bitches and niggas in penitentiary suits. I send them letters and money orders and make them my troops. That's for these females, I got no time. I gotta get mine, you cannot blind me. Addicted to a life of crime. My time is a shorty but full of car chases. We're running with John Gotti's and Scarfaces. Niggas knew I beat a gun to my own crew. A million niggas with automatics to swim through. You wonder who shot me is a clue. Stay alert, cause we coming for you and keeping money on more bitches.
Nigga, cause we mob on you tricks and you know we keeping money over bitches.
Keeping money over bitches.
Nigga, cause we mob on you tricks and you know we keeping money over bitches.
M.O.B.
Nigga, cause we mob on you tricks and you know we keeping money over bitches.
To get on YouTube and bash people and say bad things about them. It's something, in all honesty, I don't want to do. But if you're bad, I will come at you eventually, 100%. Because all these guys, they think they're in the mob. They think because they did some time, they're somebody. They're fucking nobodies. Plain and simple, they're fucking nobodies. And then they're asking people for money, you know, support my channel, send me a couple of dollars. Don't give them shit. Give them this. This is what you give them. Don't give them nothing.
Hey, everybody out there. For people that don't know, I have a Patreon channel that you can subscribe to, please. I left my family. I left my kids. I left my nightclub, my parking company, $35 million to fight the fight.
I'm not going to give you the bullshit like all these other guys give you the bullshit. This guy was made. That other guy was a stone cold killer, $35 million. The other guy, he beat up a whole bunch of people. He's a royalty, all that bullshit, bunch of bullshit, all these guys today.
I have thick skin. Anybody that wants to go after me on his personal level and my family and personal, I can do the same thing, and it's childish. They're supposed to be above this. We're supposed to be grown men and adults. That life's over. And guys like Sammy Gravano, I'm asking you straight out. Tell people how many people you shot out of those 19 people. Tell people how many people you stabbed. Stop being a politician and ducking those questions. Because you know as far as I did, you did shit. You guys with all these titles, but you're hiding in a cave like Bin Laden in Arizona. If you're that tough guy you want to talk, you're not an underboss. You're no different than Spider cleaning shoes for people. You carried the umbrella for John Gotti Sr. That's what you did. You want to bullshit people? Go ahead, tell people what you really did yourself. You're not Johnny Alite. All you guys that talk like this, you know I changed my life. And you wouldn't be too sure, even if I changed my life, these cameras weren't out here. I was the guy doing the stuff. And anybody else that talks about wanting to fight me, I'm not a little child. The only reason we talk about a fight deal is pay-per-view, the fight business, UFC, Phil Baroni. They asked us to fight for money, big money, million-dollar money. I says, the rest of these kids that want to talk about fighting, they go in the ring and fight somebody else. Let me watch you fight somebody at your age. You act like children, all you guys. Grow up. This ain't about our egos. This is about you learning some humility and doing this for the kids that are out there, the youth that are in trouble, and do the right thing, a positive thing for once. Stop making this about us. This has nothing to do with us.
I mean, you know, when it comes to Sammy, I'm a little biased, you know. I spent a little time with Sammy. I got to know Sammy. Sammy's a good guy. He's a stone cold gangster. Fuck you, fuck you, and fuck you.
Not my friend, obviously, no more. The war's on. Now, for me, the war's over now. I'm not in that life. I don't care what they think. I don't care what they do. I don't care how much money they make. I don't stay with them. I don't care how many times they call me a liar. I don't know how many times you can keep telling them the same thing, and they want a reaction. You're right. The only difference is they're trying to get the old Johnny Alite's reaction of my ego.
I don't have that ego anymore. I have humility now. And I learned that through a lot of therapy and people that are helping me.
And you can see how Alite would embellish, repetitively. And so much it got to a point, Frank, that some of the jurors would even turn their chairs. He was testifying. Now look, quick example. This is John Alite's 302s. Pretty significant, huh?
Certainly.
Now remember, the government, or Alite's book, they said I was a rat. They had 4 or 5 pieces of paper, which we're going to get to. I hope we're going to get to that.
True.
Okay? This is what a rat looks like, okay? That's what a rat looks like, okay? Hundreds of pages, over 220 people, statements and testimony against right here. But he was so bad as a witness in my trial, so poor as a witness, that they wouldn't call him again after my trial. They never called him again, not even against John Byrne. Alite pled guilty, we believe he did, to the same charge that John Burke was being charged with. He said he ordered it. He said he orchestrated it. John Burke was facing the death penalty for that case. The government didn't call Alite? Well, you were the boss, according to you. You were the boss, right? You were calling the shots. You were the shot caller. And the government wouldn't even call him. They never called him again. He gave information on over 220 people, and they never called him for one case. Why is that? You're telling me, as a crime, tell me why.
The sad part is, you get these haters or these people who are miserable with their lives, so they try to muster something up by attacking other people.
Like I said, you know, I stopped even talking about it because it's tiring, because I just, what everything I just said now. They can choose what they want. At the end of the show, they'll be writing, hey, liar, fuck him, this, that, da, da, da. And I swear I laugh about it.
Unless I see different. If someone's coming off bad to me, I'm going to come off bad to them. I'm not going to disrespect anybody over here.
You know, I texted him. I said, Jimmy, what the fuck? You know this is my wife. Why would you fucking contact my wife and, you know, talk like that? Whether it was inappropriate or not, you just don't fucking do that. I wouldn't do it to your girl. I wouldn't do it to your wife. I wouldn't, if you invited me to your home, I wouldn't come in your house if you're not there. I would wait outside until you came home, or I'd go wherever I go and come back when you're there. I would never do that. And it just comes in the character of this guy. This guy is just a fucking piece of shit. And to even interject his name with Larry Mazza and Johnny Alite, it's ridiculous. Okay, Larry was next to Greg Scarpa, and Johnny was a money guy, and I know for a fact, you know, he had a couple of clubs in Tampa. He had a glass business, he had a valet business that got sold for, I believe it was $18 million after Johnny went to jail. So this guy never, you know, interjecting his name and trying to get some legitimacy by having his name in with the same breath as these guys is just stupid. He never made a dime. You know, you were fucking robbing parking meters and vending machines. You went to jail at 22. You never hit the streets after 22. And you're trying to say that you're some fucking gangster or something? Listen, you're the furthest thing from a gangster. You're a fucking scumbag. And because any man that would do that, you can't go out and find a woman. You can't find a girl or something. You got to fuck with somebody else's with old lady. You just don't do that shit. And, you know, whatever it is, but I got Jimmy his first fucking interview, and this is how I got paid back, you know, and I told Johnny about it about 3 years ago, maybe four, I don't even remember how long ago it was, but Johnny said, look, you know, he's probably fucking drunk, just forget it, let it go, it's no big deal, block him or whatever. I said, well, it's too late because he already blocked me, he didn't have the courtesy, you know, to answer me and say, hey, Mike, you know, it was a misunderstanding, I didn't know she was your wife, blah, 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 you know, but not even that, he just fucking, just blocked me and said, you know, basically ran and fucking hid in a hole where he belongs, is, you know, which is what he is a fucking little worm.
About 3 weeks ago, one of the first things happened to me that was bizarre. There was somebody on TikTok that was impersonating me. Okay?
You told me.
And a nephew of mine picked up on it because the guy didn't know how to spell. He was having conversations with people that he knew couldn't possibly be me. Long story short, a girl who he's bothering on this TikTok site And anybody that knows me knows I won't go on that because it's Chinese government run.
Yeah, yeah.
So I would never be on TikTok. But that's besides the point. So anyway, this guy, he by mistake, he was using burner phones. By mistake, one time he called her with his regular phone number. She traced it, got in touch with me, and I had my cousin Joe call him because he knows him from the neighborhood, and I knew him from the neighborhood too, but I didn't want to get on and accuse him of anything until I knew. My cousin said in less than 10 seconds he was bawling on the phone, crying hysterically, so sorry. He's losing his mind. The drugs got to him, all kinds of stuff. I never mentioned his name, but I did put it out there that we uncovered who it was because he has a family. He has kids. He's got grandkids. And the embarrassment, you know, it's enough that he was exposed.
And stay away from all the assholes, because I tell you, there's a lot of assholes out there, 100%. And jealous motherfuckers, for sure.
This John Alite was a drug dealer and a confessed killer who testified that he had murdered three people on orders from Gotti.
There was a confrontation in the courtroom.
Right, right.
With Mr. Alite.
Yeah, after he testified, he got off the stand and he walked towards me and he smiled. He was laughing. And that's when I called him a punk and a dog. He always was a punk and a dog. He was a junkie. He was all of those things. A miscreant. He was ostracized and chased out of that neighborhood. He wasn't asked to leave. He was chased out of that neighborhood. He was a trash pill then. He's a trash pill now. He'll always be a trash pill.
And in the case of John Alite, he's rejoined with Patsy Andriano, Mike Malone, a guy named John Lito, Johnny Balls Lito, another drug dealing guy convicted of murder who testified against Angelo Prisco, and they were going to use him against me in my case as well. They were all hanging out. They were all thick as thieves. They're doing things together on the streets, right under the nose of the parole services, who's pretty much being neutralized by the FBI, by these particular control agents in the FBI. And this is not an isolated case.
Now, I have to address this because this is going on years. Gotti Jr., this is not a man or a gangster that hires his sister, Angel, Chris Casparosa, and Jr. doing videos about my family, my son, my daughter, my mother, my brother. On a personal level, he's putting up videos about them on his sites, and they're showing pictures with my daughter from behind. And showing her ass and showing my grandson and attacking people on a sexual level and on habits that people have with drugs or alcohol. And we advocate no one's perfect. But for them to do that, they're forcing my hand to come out of the woodwork and attack him on a personal level. And I don't want to do that. I'm trying to say this is not about this. You want to talk about crime? Go ahead. I'm not trying to attack his wife on a personal level and her sexual activity in the past, present, or different. This is what this guy wants out of me about his family. I've been offered book deals to do a Jackie Collins book about the Gotti's sexcapades and things, and I refused it. There's big money in it, and I won't do it. I said, this is not what my life's about. But I'm going to get into Sammy Gravano now, who stepped in to protect the Gotti's all of a sudden. He's a guy that can't control the Gotti's himself.
What is A-Light? Said something about he wanted to fight John Jr. And then he said something about his friend wants to fight John Jr.'s son. It shows how little he knows about the mafia. We never interfere with families. You want to say something about John Jr.? Go ahead. The kid is off limits. Seems to be a nice kid. Big, tall, good-looking kid. He fights in a cage. Leave him the fuck out of your conversations. That shows how little you know about the mafia. Don't go to families. So, it's probably sounding weird that I'm defending John Jr. or his son, but we don't do that. And if you do that, it's a scummy move on your part. And all of Gunsmoke, every bad guy in the country understands that. So what you're doing by challenging his son or his daughter or whoever the fuck you're talking about, you're making a tremendous mistake. And that bothers me more than calling me names or whatever the fuck you want to say about me. But that, we don't do that. Somebody will say something about my daughter because I cooperated. Just think about that for 2 minutes. Not even, because Russia hates it. But think about it as a regular person. Why would you do that? It's disgusting. It's out of line. And so if you think I'm defending John Jr., he don't need me to defend him. He can defend himself. I think he's making a mistake. I think John Jr. might be tough with his hands. So I think you're making a mistake. But the big mistake you're making is challenging the kid. Leave it the fuck out of your mouth. I didn't want to talk about these things because they're all arguing, but I felt I had to say that at least.
And as far as this Sicilian guy, Sammy, that you put up to this, he's advocating he doesn't like me because Johnny Gebbett died. Johnny Gebbett was a gang rapist convicted. He beat a girl almost to death. He shot, Johnny Gebbett shot the boyfriend because he was going to testify Sal Tamasulo. He shot Frankie DeMeo. Know your facts. And Sicilian, whatever your name is, you got a wife. How would you like your wife being beaten to half to death and being raped by five guys? Guys, better get your facts straight and what you're doing. You better change directions because I'm the only guy that's out here day after day trying to advocate for kids. We were all pieces of shit before. I start with myself and I call myself a piece of shit always. This isn't about me. This ain't about being tough guys. This is about being grown men, adults at your ages. You all should be ashamed of yourselves.
You know, this stuff here, I hope it goes away because he's getting way too much notoriety, you know, talking about Larry Mazza and Johnny A. Like, he gotta be fucking nuts, man. You shouldn't be doing it, man. And you know what? I gotta say another thing, too. Sammy Guarano had this kid on his podcast. I almost fucking, my eyes bulged out of my head when I seen the video. I was like, what the hell is he doing with this kid, you know, associating with this kid? This guy was a fucking underboss, and he's talking to a fucking, basically a peon? Come on, man. Don't believe everything his bullshit stories.
I love you guys. I love the support. The people who hate me, I love you too. Because you know what? Without your hate, I wouldn't keep on going on. And the people who love me, thank you so much for the support.
You know, I got a million stories too. When I was young, I used to do this, I used to do that or whatever. You know, we're all men now. I'm an older guy. We're all older. We got families, you know. And men don't go around conducting themselves like this, where you go behind somebody's back and you contact them and you're fucking them, trying to fuck around with their wives and shit. That shit will get you fucked up. Even a regular guy will do something drastic. So that's what it is. It's my two cents.
Now tell me who's afraid of this young thug? Look how we came up from the gutter where we slung drugs. America eats his babies, it's crazy. Will somebody save me from the systematic slavery? Got me in cuffs, I'm getting roughed up daily. Send me to jail cause I rebel on what they tell me. My life's hell, got the law trying to capture me. And then the courts and the whole force after me. I'm hitting fences, my defense is, it was senseless. It's like the whole world's against us. Then they wonder why I'm cussing, busting at the world. Don't trust me and my homies saying fuck them. Rolling in my 6-0 Impala. All about making dollars. Sometimes it makes me wanna holler. But now it's cool. And if I'm motivating, baby, make a move. Cause the thugs get lonely too. And all I heard is saying,
BYT, play a young thug. You need some loving. TLC, just
a black man.
Yeah.